one of the most common reasons that people come and seek psychotherapy really is because they're too agreeable. But what that means is they're not assertive enough. They haven't integrated their capacity for aggression, and so other people can push them around. And they're very conflict avoidant. And so the consequences of that across time is that you don't stand up for yourself well enough, and you get taken advantage of, and that spirals badly downward. And so partly what you do when you're doing assertiveness training with people is you find out what they're angry about. And they're usually angry if they're not assertive enough, because other people are taking advantage of them, or you could say because they're not putting their own necessities forward with enough force. It's hard to distinguish between those two things. But anyways, you get them to talk about what they're angry about. That often makes them cry, often many times. And then you get them to kind of envision what they would want to have instead, which they're often afraid to do, because people are afraid to think about what they want, because that makes it more clear when they're not getting it, and that's painful, right? Or maybe they're afraid of hoping, so they won't specify a clear aim. But anyways, you get them to think about what they might want instead, you get them to think about the costs of not pursuing that, and then you help them develop strategies for integrating their aggression and with their thinking so that they can come up with a plan to approach the world in a more confident way. So for example, someone might come to me and say, I'm being bullied badly at work. And so then I'll say, well, what are your options? You have to put up with it? Well, we'll figure that out, because maybe you do. Maybe you don't have options. But here's how to find out. Get your damn CV together so it's pristine, right? It's ready to go. Get over your fear of a new interview, because people are generally afraid of that. Get over your fear of applying for a new job. Start thinking about what it would mean to have a different job. Start thinking about what it would mean to have a better job even, because maybe your fear is just making you stuck here. But I can tell you one thing, if someone's picking on you at work and you don't have options, you lose. So you get the person to start building a strategy. It's like, okay, if you're going to tell this person to stop, you have to know how to make them stop. And the one thing you need for sure is an option. And if you don't have an option, then maybe we start thinking about the fact that you need some more training or something like that. Because you cannot negotiate if you don't have any power. So, because while, especially if you're dealing with someone who's really out to get you or really disagreeable, if you don't have a leg to stand on, they'll just push you over. And maybe they'll jump on you too, because that's what they're like and they enjoy it anyways. So it's no joke. So you put your options behind you and then you start to think about strategy. So I tell people, look, if you're being harassed at work, you document it every time it happens and you write it down. So you've got like 20 stories about it, and it's fully documented. And then you go confront the person at some point, but with at least 3 pieces of evidence. And you have some sense of what you tell them about what will happen if they don't stop. So you have to figure out, well, if they don't stop, what are you going to do about it? Leave? Not if you can't leave. So you have to be able to, what is it, wield a big stick and speak softly. But you see, that way that's how you take your aggression, which is an absolutely necessary part of your psyche, and manifest it up into a sophisticated means of dealing with the world. You don't just suppress it. You say, well, I should be able to put up with it, or I wish I wasn't so angry, or something. It's like, forget that. That's all that'll happen is your blood pressure will stay high and you'll die of a heart attack, because anger, for example, is a very toxic emotion. And it does cause heart damage over time. It's the only emotion that we really know that's been linked to things like cardiovascular risk. And anger is toxic, because it's like you're driving a car, you're stepping on the gas and pushing on the brake at the same time, because anger tells you to run away and to attack at the same time, because you don't know what's going to happen. And so it really amps up the physiological demand on your body. And so if you including your heart and your musculature. So if you stay like that for like 10 years, you know, you're going to age 20 years. And that's a bad plan. So you know, you take your underground emotions and you integrate them into a sophisticated reality. Now, Jung said, so